anyone wanting to bring a cat home to be a part of their family, there's plenty of opportunities to do so, but do you know all the things that you should actually consider when choosing your feline? Dr. K is joining us today, of course, from Dr. K's Pet Clinic, our visiting vet. Thanks so much for joining us, Dr. K. Now, you were telling me that when someone wants to buy a cat, sometimes there's some things that maybe they overlook when they choose a cat. What should people keep in mind?
Well, I think, first of all, you just go ahead and wherever you're going, take a look at all the cats that are there, you know. Mm-hmm. Usually people, there's like a zillion at the Humane Society.
Yeah, and at the Canyon County Animal Shelter as well, there's lots
Correct.
And lots of cats at any given
Correct.
Time.
And the bad thing about that, the average euthanasia rate in those Humane Societies is 60% of the dogs get euthanized and 70% of the cats. And so if you're going to want to get a cat, I'd probably try to go to the Humane Society
Definitely,
to try to
yeah.
adopt one out.
And there's never going to be too few cats to adopt at one of those places.
No,
so yeah, definitely
like
adoption
a lot,
is the best way to go because it helps on so many
right.
fronts. So you're at the animal shelter, the Humane Society, wherever you are looking at these cats. What kind of stuff will help you make a good judgment call on what cat's
well,
right for
I'll
you?
Well, just take a look at them and take a look at all of them and see the selection. I think that helps. And everybody has their own little pet wants and mm-hmm. dislikes about things. And then obviously you want to go ahead and try to hold the kitty and see how it attaches to you.
Rather than just going on site, some people, you know, oh, that one's pretty, but the prettiest ones may not act,
right,
the most, in the most pretty way.
It's because it's not only looks, you know, you need to realize how they're going to act when you have them. I think if it's going to be an indoor cat, you probably want to get a short-haired one because that hair is like, well, some of you are going to be cleaning hair from now until doomsday in the house. So I think the short-haired ones for the inside will work better. I think that's important. Make sure that they at least look healthy to you. Check the ears for ear mites. You can see brown wax in them. Check the eyes and all that business and so that you know what you're getting.
And so when you're out there looking for those cats, at least the hair length you were talking about, if you do get a long-haired cat, at least realize that you're going to have a lot more cleanup and stuff
Correct.
Going on, maybe some more allergens in the house. So that's important to remember, too, if someone in your family maybe is allergic or whatever.
Right.
So, and when you bring those cats home, usually you have a little, you know, trial period. You want to make sure if you have dogs or other animals, too, that they get along, right?
Right. So. And if you have other cats, I'd probably separate that cat for a few days to make sure how healthy it's going to be
okay.
so that it won't give your other cat some sort of disease.
Okay.
Okay.
Good point, because you want to keep the animals that you already have healthy as
Correct.
Well. So just a few ideas to keep in mind when you're choosing your cat. And again, Humane Society and Canyon County Animal Shelter, any shelter really that you go to, always going to have so many cats at any given time. So yeah, help them out, help the cats out, and make sure to adopt from there. So we appreciate your
Great.
Tips this morning, Dr. K.